Today, I'm going to be talking about how to show up on YouTube search. It's not a very good place in terms of growing because you could grow 10, 100 times much faster by just showing up on YouTube. For me, I would not really focus on showing up on YouTube search, even though it's the best way to grow when you have no audience, when you have zero subscribers, and when you don't want to bring relatives or anyone else into your YouTube channel and show them your YouTube channel. It's really the only way, or for me, it's the way that brought me and got me really close to around 30,000 subscribers. It's really a stepping stone when you don't have an audience or you have zero subscribers. It's the way to grow. Showing up on search and solving people's problem can really help you and to enable you to go from that zero mark to a specific mark like 10,000, 30,000. But for me, after 10,000, it's much more likely for you to, or even 1,000, you know, it's much more likely for you to go after suggested videos than YouTube search, because YouTube search is not a very good place in terms of growing, because you could grow 10, 100 times much faster by just showing up on suggested videos rather on YouTube search. But today, we're going to talk about how to show up on YouTube search, so that's what we're going to do. For me, it's mainly the three things. There's mainly three things that enable us to actually rank on YouTube videos for me specifically. And there's more factors than just these three things. But for me, I think that these three things are much more very important than the other things that are there. So the first thing is audience retention. You really need good audience retention to rank, because you know YouTube cares about watch time. And why does YouTube care about watch time is because YouTube wants to make money. I think every platform needs to make money to sustain themselves, and YouTube especially, the only way that it makes, or most of its money it makes, is by getting people to watch YouTube. If YouTube gets people to watch YouTube, the people who watch YouTube watch ads, which generates revenue for YouTube and the content creators, which ultimately benefits the platform and keeps the platform growing, basically, or sustains the platform. So I think audience retention helps YouTube to get that watch time, which keeps people on YouTube. And that's why watch time is such an important metric to really focus on in 2019. And, you know, really audience retention can help you do that. If you have a high audience retention and a lot of people watch your videos all the way through, you get a higher watch time, which helps YouTube to actually promote you throughout, not only in search but also in suggested videos and other things like that. So yeah, audience retention, I think it's the most important thing you should be focusing on in terms of growing your audience. Even if you have zero subscribers, you should actually just try to focus on audience retention, because even if one, two people watch it and they watch it all the way through, I think YouTube's going to try to promote it to much more people. And you know, that's how you grow. So yeah, audience retention is a very important factor in growing your YouTube channel, and especially showing up in YouTube search. The second thing for me is thumbnails and titles. Like when you actually get promoted by YouTube, the first thing that people see when YouTube promotes you is your title and thumbnail, because if they don't click on the thumbnail and the title, they're not gonna watch your video. It's very simple. You need to make thumbnails and titles better so you get a higher click-through rate, especially when in 2018 or 2017 they released impressions and click-through rates. It was a game changer, because now you could actually see how, if your thumbnails were converting into views and how much impressions you were getting, and you know, you could see all those promotions and stuff. We could not see it like before, and it was really what we needed. Like a lot of people requested YouTube for those impressions and click-through rates data, and we finally have it, so we should probably take advantage of it. And I think most people aren't taking advantage of it. The people like from 2016 really know what I'm talking about here, because it's such an important metric in terms of like how your thumbnails are doing. And you could really improve your thumbnails if you know that your thumbnails suck. And you know, the first thing to solving any problem is to identifying there is a problem. So yeah, I think you need to really improve your thumbnails and titles. And the trick I use is, when you have a title like how to show up in YouTube search, I would use different phrases like how to get ranked on YouTube on the thumbnail, like putting text like rank on YouTube, and then on the title there's like show up on YouTube search. So those are two different things, like rank and show up, right? So I think using complementary words on your thumbnail and title actually help your thumbnail, from what I've seen. and even thumbnail tactics like using complementary colors. There's a lot of things we'll dive into later in previous tutorials, but for now, I think thumbnail and titles are most important because it really gets you that initial click from people to watch your videos when YouTube promotes you. And YouTube also does this testing thing on YouTube search. I've seen it, like, they show your video for a certain amount of time and see how it performs, and if it performs good in click-through rate, it's just basically the amount of people that click your thumbnail and title to actually watch the video, which is click-through rate. If you have a high click-through rate, YouTube actually starts promoting and actually doing more promotions for that video, which helps your video. So, you know, having a good thumbnail and title never hurts. I think you should put how much you're spending right now, you should spend 3 times more on creating a better thumbnail and better title. Like, if you have a click-through rate of 14%, which is enormously very, very good, you should try to improve it by looking at the data and, you know, just looking at all these tips. Like, just go to Google and search up how to make a good thumbnail for YouTube, and you'll see all these, like, advices by these great people who have done a lot of testing. And same for titles, you know, gotta have a good title. So the third thing for me is basically that content. You need to make content that actually satisfies your audience, so they want to come back and watch more of it, right? In terms of showing up on YouTube search, like, when you're trying to show up on YouTube search, it's most helpful when you create content that actually helps people, like it answers people's questions. So if you can actually identify what your audience or what your target audience is actually trying to look for, like if you have a cooking audience, how to cook bacon could be a question. You could try to answer it by creating content, and then if that content's actually helpful, you'll also have a high retention. So having actually helpful and satisfying content for your target audience is very important. Like, you need to have a content that satisfies your audience so they would want to watch more. This helps a lot. Like, also having content in series. Like, you should have series content. So for me, if you look at my channel, I say, okay, how to turn off restricted mode. I create a video on that, and then it does very well. Then I do it for phone. Like, how to turn off restricted mode on phone. So people are getting satisfied and are actually being helped by that one piece of content, which is like how to turn off restricted mode on YouTube. And they're looking on my channel, or it's showing up in the suggested feed. There's another video, how to turn off restricted mode on phone. It's very relatable topics. So the first video helped them. They most likely would want to turn it off on phone as well. So they would actually convert and watch that other video, which would generate my audience retention and also boost up my watch time, which would enable me to show up on search again. And it would be much more easier to show up on search, you know, it'd be more likely to show up on search that way. So having series in mind and making helpful content is the way to go if you want to show up on search. And the other thing is, there's a lot of things like metadata and having like proper tags, descriptions, titles, and having those keywords on your description and tags really help you as well. You need to have, like, if your video is about how to show up on YouTube search, you need to have, like, in the description, like, if your video's on cooking bacon, you need to have, like, in the description about bacon. You need to have clarity in your description. Like, you need to have your description short and sweet, right? You don't want to make it a whole essay. You don't want to make it a blog. Just make it short and make it really relevant to the cooking bacon thing. And in your tags also, have relevant tags. Don't put a bunch of things in your tags. Don't spam on your tags. Just put relevant things. You don't need to use all those 500 characters that are available in the tag section. You could just use like 300. And I think that's all for metadata. People get really, like, tied up on making really amazing metadata. You don't need to have really amazing metadata. You just need to have amazing content, high retention, and amazing titles and thumbnails. And I think that's the way to grow on YouTube. And it actually helps in suggested video as well. It helps you enormously when you're trying to show up on YouTube search. So, yeah.